Yo, welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. It is Testimony Tuesday. If it's your first time in the neighborhood, I gotta set the neighborhood rules. But before we do anything in the neighborhood, we kick off our shoes, we relax our feet, we set the motherfucking vibe. This is the time to go get whatever it is that you get to start your day or wind your day down, to get the tea, to get the gossip, to get the lesson, to get the message. Whatever it is that you get to prepare you for the hype, go get that shit while we run this and set the motherfucking vibe. We probably gonna get a motherfucking commercial because I ain't start this shit before I started the video and the podcast. I got the podcast going today, YouTube and I remember. This is the vibe for the day.
Jet setter.
Go get her.
Nothing better.
Alright, yo, welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. I hope that you enjoyed that vibe. You already know I can't even get through the intro because I got so much shit I want to talk about. But y'all already know we gotta set the motherfucking neighborhood. The community rules, bitch. The community rules for the newcomers. If it's your first time in the motherfucking neighborhood, what I need you to do is I need you to go bring it back to the bottom of the map. I need you to go all the way back to the very beginning and check out a video called Welcome to the Neighborhood. Welcome to the motherfucking neighborhood. That's what I always say, but it's just called Welcome to the Neighborhood. It's the very first video that I uploaded. You have to watch, or you should watch, from Welcome to the Neighborhood in chronological order until the point you came in on a journey. So that's the first video, the second video, the third video, the fourth video, the fifth video, the sixth video, seventh video, so on and so forth until the point you came in on the journey. What's the point you came in on the journey? I'm so fucking glad that you asked. it's the video or the podcast that you clicked that made you say, who is this girl? What the fuck is she talking about? What the fuck is she doing? Do I wanna be involved in her life? Do I really want to sip her tea? That's the video. That's the point that you came in on the motherfucking journey. If you came in in the middle of the motherfucking journey, we follow two people here. First one being spirit, God, universe, whatever it is that you do or don't believe in. As for me and my house, y'all already know I serve the Lord. So we follow God first, and then we follow Uncle Luke. We don't stop. We pop that pussy. We keep going past the point that we came in on the motherfucking journey. If you came in the middle of the journey, we keep it at that part. We keep going past the point we came in on a motherfucking journey. And if you're watching these videos as they are being uploaded, you watched past the point you came to the end on a journey into the very last video uploaded. If you came in, shit, I keep fucking it up. My brain feel like Groundhog's Day right now. If you're watching these videos as they are being uploaded, you are getting backstage passes. Hopefully God say the same to see greatness being made or whatever. You get to see God's will being done. I'm trying to follow God and see wherever following his will or trusting God, wherever that takes me. I'm a girl who follow my spirit. This is the story of a girl and God. If you want to know a little bit about the channel and why I am doing what I'm doing, I would tell you to go and see a video called A Thing About Hope, The Thing About Hope, one of them motherfuckers. But if you start at the very beginning, you'll run into that bitch. If you don't know if you want to watch all, I know at this point it's like 160 videos. If you don't want to watch all 160 videos, I'm telling you, you just want to go back. I'm telling you now because you're going to want to know how all of this shit started. But if you just want a little bit of tea, I would say go see the video called Noah's Ark. I would say go see a video called The Audacity of Hope. I would say go see a video called Let's See What We Can Make Today. And it was another one, but I forgot what the fuck that one was. So I would say go see a couple of those. Those are some of the juicier ones. But you really won't understand what I'm talking about unless you watch these in order. I try to record every day, but I give myself breaks so I don't record every day. And I have to teach myself it's okay not to record every day. But like I said, this is the story of a girl. This is the story of a girl and God. All right. That part. All right. Today is a good day. Didn't have to carry the cake. Y'all gonna get used to me singing that shit. So first things first, I ran this song because I'm thinking about my little boo. I text him. I think I told y'all I text him. I was like, we can't talk no more. I deserve more than this or whatever because he living with Red, y'all. He living with fucking Red. But I did miss him because, like I told y'all, he was my goon before anything else. And I just definitely, I don't know why, he real heavy on my mind. I don't want to fuck with him because he be doing fuck ass shit, but he real heavy on my mind. So but one of the things he told me, I asked him something. He is like, Lee, he called me Lee. He say, Lee, you one in a million. And this song just been, you know, playing in my head. So I'm definitely thinking about him. I'm definitely praying about it. I don't know, I'm just trying to let God, but I don't deserve, you know, what's going on. So I don't know, but I don't know all that's going on. So we'll see. We're gonna let that shit play out. But today is Testimony Tuesday. This the stone that I had in my bra. I got a fucking Mindful Soul box. Hopefully that comes before I hop on a plane. I'm gonna do, my sister ordered me this little thing from Ipsy, so I'm excited. I'm gonna open that with you guys. And don't kill me, like I said, what's the name of that video? It wasn't Walking Like I Talk It. Spiritual Saturday. This Spiritual Saturday. Whatever that spirit, this past Spiritual Saturday was. Y'all gotta watch these in order so y'all gonna know what the fuck I'm talking about. But whatever this Spiritual Saturday was, it's like you get to see the ups and the downs. And so 1 week post just all out wanting to quit and being upset just before I open this with you guys. Is like I'm a little bit more amped about what I'm doing because I've been working with one of my coworkers. Shout out to Eddie. He's just an old, I don't think Eddie old. I don't know how old Eddie is. Eddie Asian, Korean. I want to say he Asian. And you can't tell how old he is. But I found out he was a Scorpio today. I was just like, when I find out people are Scorpios, and I already have a idea of Eddie in my head. So, but when I realized he was a Scorpio, I told him, I said, that's why we resonate, because he's like training me and coaching me. And I really realized that what I'm doing is really something It's really something great. It's really something cool. Even when I want to quit, and I don't like, I want to tell you that I don't know my boss's intentions for me. I really do feel like she'd be coming after me, but I will say this, that it's a lot of help. I'm getting as much help. Like, I ain't never received this type of help. Like, this is one of them favor ain't fairs type of help. Like, I'm definitely getting fine tuned and molded into, something great, and I can see it and I can feel it. And I'm very honored for it. And, I can feel myself learning. I still got a lot more learning to do. I'm actually going to put myself in some self-imposed classes when I come back, in January to hit the ground running. I'm about to really take advantage of it. I've been taking advantage of it, but I'm going to take advantage of it even more, and make myself even more valuable. So there's that, but I don't know, like, I really don't know if she meant it for my bad or meant it for my good, but either way it go, for Testimony Tuesday, I'm grateful for my job, I'm grateful for the people on my team, because I realize that everybody got a role to play, and I don't know if it's, but had it not been for all of the things that happened, I wouldn't maybe be as zealous as I am about what I'm doing. I try not to let my compassion, my motivation be, stem from hate or bad things, but, because then that means that I need bad things to keep myself going, but that's not it. But it's just like, I'm looking at it differently, and I appreciate the role that everybody playing in my life that's keeping me on track. Like, as I sit and I train with Eddie, I learn so much, and I really get to pick his brain, and he's so wise and smart. And I just watch every aspect of him, of how he deals with his family and all those things. And I'm just so honored. Not only am I like in a 1% for what I do, I'm probably in a 1% for my age and my race and where I come from. And so I'm just very grateful for that. And so I kind of wanted to talk to you today, to you guys today about, I made a video that I saluted the peace dealer about embracing the cringe, but I never talked about what, you know, like the actual cringe and what it feel like when you in the cringe. Like, just because you embrace the pain doesn't mean that it's going to feel good. And last week was definitely a cringe worthy week. And so in those days, in those moments while you in the cringe, you're going to be mad. You're going to be upset. You're going to want to cry. Cause I had to go back and watch my fucking video to really, you know, like I be talking to myself, and I gotta remember that I be talking to myself sometimes. And a lot of the stuff that I said, I even did some readings, and they applied to me today. And it was really slightly creepy. I was like, "Oh, bitch, you like, like, damn, you that kind of bitch." And I really am. And so, but like, while you're in the cringe, like, don't let nobody tell you how to feel when you in the cringe. Fuck them. Like, last week was my cringe. I embraced it. I accepted it. I especially looking back at it. But let me tell you, that shit was awful. It was absolutely awful. I felt worthless. They say I'm worthless. Like a penny with a hole in it. I felt like a penny with a hole in it. And I don't know if that was their intention to make me feel like a penny with a hole in it or not. But by me feeling like a penny with a hole in it, I had to make the conscious decision to not feel like that, to make the conscious decision to believe in myself and to really own my worth and know who I am and know what I bring to the motherfucking table. Not in the, like I said, not in a cocky way, in a humble way, but in a respectful way. Like, nah, like you telling me what I am and I'm not that. And I won't even accept that energy. So don't bring that around me. And so it kind of caused me to sit with my back up straight and really like reject what people projected onto me, but in a respectable way. But the cringe teaches you that. Without the cringe, you can't learn those things. But don't think, like, the cringe uncomfortable. Don't nobody like pain unless you're a masochist. And even in masochistic ways, too much of a masochist, you could kill yourself. Too much pain, anything in excess is poison. Rummy said that. And I always say that to you guys. So, if we go back to them cars, the pizza had, like, it ain't look like what I expected. It ain't the growth and the strength. It ain't look like the cringe. The cringe ain't look like what I thought it was going to look like. I wanted it to be a lot gentler. I wanted it to be a lot easier. But it's not. And what I will say is that showed me who my friends were. That showed me, like, for real. And it's so crazy because I'm so young. But a lot of my friends way older than me. Like, when I say older than me, I mean older than me. But it showed me who my support system was. And I tell you guys, like, especially having gone through, like, what I've gone through, a lot of people, I don't really fuck with a lot of people. But, like, Eddie, like, I trust him. And I, like, and he gave me some really, really good advice as to how to proceed and move forward. And to really take advantage of it. And so I ask all the questions I can ask. And I'm going to stick with it. For as long as guys say I should stick with it. And I really do. Like, it's an opportunity to grow and really maneuver in this culture. But last week, guys, I was up. I was fed up. Like, I ain't want to do it. And it's so funny because I listened to a reading. I think Shanique read for me one time. And she was like, don't quit. And I was like, I don't know what that applied to. And then it was a whole bunch of different things. But all of the things that... like, everything just popped up when it needed to. It was something that said, let your friends help you. And so, I let down my guard and I let people help me. But I let the right people help me. Like I told y'all in the reading from this weekend, like, it's a lot of people that's going to come with their cups. You got to be able to discern who there to help you and who not. And sometimes your enemies help you too. But you still got to understand how that works. So, that's low-key. That's about me embracing the cringe. It was very, 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 very interesting. Last week was very interesting. But I'm going to have up weeks and down weeks like that. Like I said, this behind the scenes. At some point, as I grow, I'll start taking y'all. Like, you, I don't know if you'll ever see, like, me. Like, imagine Queen Elizabeth when she out queening. And then when she go home and she take off the makeup and she not the queen. Like, this is the Queen Elizabeth of confessionals. You know what I'm saying? Just my inner thoughts so that y'all can see it. And at some point, like, by the time I release this, you will have already seen what the prim and proper together looks like. And then you'll want to know how I got there. And this is what these videos are for. God say the same. So like I be feeling like a hoe because I told the little boo I wouldn't go text him no more, and I told him to tell his little chick I wouldn't go text him no more. But I did because I just told him, I said, I miss you. Because I do. I really do. Because like we was cool, and I may not ever talk to him again. We may not ever speak again, but I did and I do. But I was like, you know, I miss you. But I told him, I was like, I'm not bipolar, but like, I just assess my feelings. And I don't mean to come off as that, but like, it's that initial anger. And then it's that calm. It's like that calm. And I've still got some more calming down to do, cause I'm still very, very, very salty about all the things that happened. I'm not going to dismiss it. I forgive you, but I don't forget what you did. And I won't ever forget how you handled me. But it's whatever it is, for whatever reason, I can't tell what reason you doing what you doing. God is not a God of confusion. But it's for my good. And I feel crazy because I'm so excited that, you know, even I just decided, like, I feel like I should be mad about it, but I'm not. I'm excited. I'm excited I get to ask questions. I'm excited that I get help. To be demeaning to me and to make me feel it may not. I'm not sure, but I'm just going to look at it as a positive thing, as I'm going to give you as much help as I can so you can be as great as you can be. And if that's the way if that's the outcome, and if the outcome of whatever you're doing, as long as the outcome is income, I think that's what I'm going to name today's Testimony Tuesday. As long as the outcome is income. So there's that. All right. So I'm so childish because after I finish this, I'm actually going to do some work outside of, like, I realized that, since I molded my life as such to really be able to work and do what I want to do, I'm going to stop complaining about working before and after work. I'm going to start working before work and working after work, to get some things done. Like, I got a plan and we're going to work that bitch, and I'm going to let you know how that shit work. So guys, I got to get my numbers up to a certain thing. And I need to get my ticket count up. And I plan to blow that shit out the water. I want to do it this month. I don't know that I'll be able to, cause I'll be out of town. If I am, I'll be super excited about that. So I want to get my numbers up, but I also want to do that while still doing neighborhood hope dealer while still being on brag and creating there and still creating programs within programs within programs. And God say the same, if I win this competition, I want to also be able to implement those programs within the company as well. So y'all pray for me. 2021 is the takeoff. Not so 2020 was the takeover and 2021 is the takeoff. And so God say the same, just protect me, keep me on the path that you would have for me. Your will be done. Keep placing people in my life along my path that are meant to guide me, that I cannot miss, God. That's my prayer. And if I ever I am redirect, if ever I am misdirected, God, please redirect me, and place me where you need me to be and not exactly where I want to be. And sometimes those things line up, and sometimes they do, sometimes they don't, and sometimes they do. So there's that simple little prayer a real bitch got going on. I can't wait to watch. I'm gonna watch The Real Housewives of Atlanta, The Real Housewives of Potomac. And then I'm going to, and while I'm doing that, I'm going to type up some stuff and get ready. I got some meetings planned for 2021 already that I need to get on the books. I got some, meeting notes that I need to get into, teams for a couple projects that I'm working on. So that when I go home, my sister, she don't know this, but we have brunch on Saturday. So we order her. She told me she wanted one of these cakes. So we order her a motherfucking cake. So we going to brunch on Saturday. I told y'all COVID safe, spending time with my family, really just cut up, have a good time. I'm going to see some friends that I haven't seen in a really long time. And that should be a breath of fresh air. And it's the first time that we all get together and we all okay. Like we ain't all been together in a really long time, and last time we was all in some shit, but all of us okay. All of us, what Fabulous say, whole crew look like we robbed the bank, but all we make is deposits. And it's women, and it's boss ass women. So I'm so excited. I really hope my goal is to have them come down here for the gala with me, because I don't like these snooty bitches in Charlotte. Like I realized today that I'm one of the boys, and all of my homeboys got wives and girlfriends, and so I can't be one of the boys no more, because their wives and their girlfriends don't allow them to have friends like that. You know what I'm saying? And it's sad, because I miss all my, like, I really am one of the boys. Like for real. If you ever see me with my boys, like, I just think about the galas I go to when we go. And my homeboy Chris, I love him so much. I need to, and I can't really check on him, because that ain't really how his life's set up. But that's one of my goals to the day I die. If I ever make it to the White House, like, he already on the list. Like, he just always been there for me. But like him, Dorian, Rashawn, the mental health guy, I'm always like, if we all together, like if it's a group of girls and a group of guys and they all mutual friends, I'm always with the guys. I ain't never fucked none of them or sucked none of them or nothing like that ever. Like I have made out with one of their friends one time, real drunk. And I told one of their friends that I fucked the dog shit out of him. But that's the gist of it. I wanted one of their friends, one of their little bald-headed friends, but he ain't want me. He this nigga trying to make me chase him. Nigga, the fuck? And then the little girls that be in the clique be looking at me like I'm, bitch, I'll beat you up. I'm not gonna beat anyone up. But I'm one of the guys. I really am one of the guys, and they know it. And like they know I'm one of the guys. Like it ain't no so I miss my guy friends, but like my girlfriends, like my neighbor, she probably more of a guy too. She's one of my friends. My friend Sheila, she's one of my friends. I don't have many friends though. Like I don't fuck with too many people. There ain't too many people I call friends or I really trust like that. But my people back home, like they from back home, you know what I'm saying? So it's like I can't wait to kick it with them, and I want them to come out here and really show these hoes how to party. These bitches be so snooty, and it's just like, oh, I can't be. My sister know me, like she be fussing at me all the time. She's like, you be so fucking her birthday tomorrow. Happy birthday to the best big sister in the whole wide world. I got the best big sister and the best little brother and the best mama and the best daddy and the best niece, and they all beat your family up straight like that. I gotta send her some money. Oh, I definitely need to send that to her ASAP. But So I want them to come out here and really party with us, will party with me. And like I said, we all in a different space in our life. So it'll be different. Like I told my sister last time she was here, I was poor. I had to get a rental car. I had no car. My house was just like, but it hit different when you got a little bread. You know what I'm saying? So there's that. So I got a detox tin here. I'm going to be salty about it, but I've been eating a lot of cheese and shit. So I've been putting a little bit of it in my, I'm reading a message. Put a little bit in my tea this morning, but I just left my bag in here today, so I'm gonna be shitting. It says, may this day bring you peace, tranquility, and harmony. Live righteously and love everyone. And my other tea bag earlier said, let it come to you. And so I've decided I'm not chasing anything. I'm just gonna let it come to me. All right, guys. Oh, let me tell y'all something. So, only a bitch that don't really like you will buy you some shit like some chocolate croissants while you stuck in fucking quarantine. HD, a lady that I work for, she bought me these. And this is like a sin. Why would you buy me this shit? Why would you buy me chocolate bread? It was a Christmas gift. So, thank you, HD, I guess. I don't know. Like, this one of them gifts that I just side-eyed. All right. Now, for the moment, I'm so childish. So, I was like, should I watch my show first so I can talk about it? And with, like, because most of the time when I watch these shows, I find something interesting to talk about. But I was like, nah, I want to open my package. I want to open my package. So I'm opening this. I don't know what's in here. I feel like it's a, so a little makeup bag. It got shit in it. I'm excited. Oh, so random. So I stopped wearing lipstick and shit like that because my ex ain't like that shit, but I love a good lip. And I'm trying to figure out what I'm wearing to this motherfucking brunch because I got so many looks I want to wear. So, alright. So I got this lip balm. That's perfect. It's by Beauty For Real. Let's see. I'm going to open it. I'm going to show y'all the color. This is pretty cool. So my sister got me a couple of these. She got me some for a couple months, so I should get one at least for a few months. All right, this is a nice little maroon color. I don't know if y'all can see it. Yeah, like that, like that. So that's cute. I can't wait to wear that. All right, what's this? Ultra Tip Shapeless Eyebrows. Precise brow pen. I don't do my brows because look at them. They fucking perfect already. I'm gonna take it home though. I'm gonna try it though. And the crazy thing is I really like to play in makeup. I don't wear makeup, but I really like to play in it. What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? I don't see y'all. That's how you know. Like I don't even know what the fuck this is. But this is it. This is what it looked like. This the box. My brow pencil. I don't know. There we go. So that's what this is. I'm gonna play with it. I'm gonna be playing in makeup. I'm such a girly girl sometimes. Oh, what is this? I always wanted some popping lip gloss. All right, so I got this Laura Glossin Laura Makeup Labs. So this is cute. See, I don't know how to see this ring light beat. Let me see. I don't know if I can make it warmer. And shit, that bitch got light bright like a diamond bright. Yeah, y'all definitely can't see that. I'm sorry that I suck at this, guys. I'm trying to become like a professional YouTuber, bitch. I don't fucking know. Like, I shouldn't be putting my mouth on this because it's got Corona written all over it.
It's got Corona written all over it.
I'm childish, but I do need a good lip gloss. Come on, my lips be popping. Is the color? know if y'all can see that. Probably not. But shit, I tried. I was literally just thinking I needed some fucking lip gloss. And it's minty. Okay, so it tell me everything that I got. So confidence and cream. Want to keep your glow going through the winter. Alright, so I'm gonna put all of this stuff back up. Cause y'all know a bitch lips be looking a little crunchy, bitch. Ooh. So I got some face mask. I love it. I love a good mask. Are these sheet masks? Oh yeah, so it's sheet mask. So it's the kind of mask moisturizing and dewy skin. So this one, it got acai in it. My mom was like, I got feet. And then avocado. Alright. So I got these. I'll probably put one of these on tonight. And I got this confidence in cream. I feel like anti-aging cream, that's so racist, forgive me. But I feel like that's only for old white women. Bitch. Black don't crack the fuck. Alright, it says skin was soft and smooth, looked rejuvenated, skin felt younger and healthier, pores appeared more minimized. So, this is what it looked like. This is the little compartment that it came in. This is the little box it came in. Y'all see my little cute nails? Christmas nails. All right. Oh, sorry, fucking, I always want to call y'all iPad. Sorry, podcast. Y'all can't see. Anti-aging cream. I'm giving my face a rest because under my eyes and like right above my eyes were hurting. And I don't know if it was because I was using too much of the toner or what. My skin is popping. Like, I be looking at my cheeks and shit. They be so rosy and shit. I be like, bitch, you cute. So, this what I got or whatever, boy. So, this is cool. This is cute. I'm excited to share these with you. So, I get this from Ipsy.com. Like I said, my sister sent this one to me. I feel like I may be getting another one. I'm not sure. But this is the packaging it came in. And this is a cute little makeup bag. It's like so soft. And I needed another little carry makeup bag so I can throw this in my purse. So I haven't heard anything back from the competition. One of the things I'm going to tell y'all, like, if I win, I'm going to buy myself a Louboutin bag. I don't know if I said that. I'm going to buy myself a Louboutin bag. I know which one I want. But I ain't heard nothing back yet. So I would say tomorrow would be the deadline. They can let us know Thursday, but that shouldn't be crazy because I don't know, but hopefully tomorrow I'll know something, even if I didn't make it to the final round, but I hope that I did. Pause. Shop SavageXFenty. I need to watch this. I'm going to wake up at the crack of ass and watch in the morning. I have so much shit to do. There's that. I always got so much shit to do. That's why I can't wait for this little vacay. But this was cute. Shout out to my big sis for sending me this shit. This was definitely an awesome little thing. And I'll definitely unbox these with y'all. So this came with a glam bag. New for 2021 glam bag X. A quarterly limited edition of 7 to 8 full product sizes. $350. Up to $350. So this is pretty cool. And I really like my nails. I really like them. So I probably actually put one of these on. A nourishing mask. Dewy skin. Which one do I want to do? And sit and work and do my fucking wrinkle care. I'm going to do the acai one. Even though I just put some shit on my face. How many masks are in here? I feel like it's only one. Yeah, I feel like it's only one. So because I think it's only one, I'm gonna wait and do this one and do it tomorrow. And I'm gonna use this after I do it when I get off. I ate a salad. I'm probably gonna fix me a little plate of spaghetti. And call it a day. All right, guys, today has been Testimony Tuesday, ho. It's been Testimony Tuesday, ho. Take some time and really reflect on what it is that you, like, reflect on your cringe. And don't be upset. Like, don't think that you gotta willingly, like, when you in the cringe, you gotta just be like, oh, yeah, I love this. Nah, when you in the cringe, you gonna freak the fuck out. And it's so crazy because, like I said, I felt like I was talking to myself in my videos, which I was, but it's just like, I forget sometimes the shit that I say to myself. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I forget the shit that I say to myself. Like, because at the end of the day, I'm my own biggest fan. And I really do make these. I make these for myself, for real. To remind myself how far I come. Like, I've always done it. Like I said, that's why I got my blog. I remember when. And that's kind of how I even got started on this journey. Because I realized so long ago from reading those blogs, like, it never looked like what you expect. But it's always right on time. So there's that. One of these teas. Spicy. I don't know how long I've been cleaning out with caffeine, but I feel like it's been at least a year. One of the little chicks was like, do you eat, so no caffeine, do you eat chocolate? And you know what? She's a sweet lady, but I hate when people do that motherfucking shit. Bitch, listen, if I tell you I don't eat caffeine, like, I don't. And if it's chocolate, okay, well, bitch, what? Now, yes, I do eat chocolate. So, now what? Now, we're here. So, then you really don't not eat caffeine, okay? And that does what? You saying that does what? Well, I just want to, no, don't. I listen. And that's the thing, too. I really have to learn about. Don't try to take care of me. I've been taking care of myself. And I appreciate you. I know you're not coming from a horrible place. I know you're just trying to help. Don't. When I need your help, I ask you. I'm one of those people. That's so bitchy of me, but I'm serious. Don't. Anyways, so I've been clean. I do get my chocolate fix, like this fucking chocolate croissant shit. I'm probably going, like, no disrespect, I'm probably going to throw them in the garbage because I don't need that shit in my house. I purposely don't keep certain shit in my house. I don't have any junk food or anything in my house because I eat it. Like, I know what I can control. I know how to control myself. I know how to trick myself. I know my downfalls. I know. And it's certain shit I could just quit cold. But, like, right now, I'm PMSing. And I want some fucking carbs. I want some fucking chocolate. Dipped in chocolate. I want some fucking mochi. I ain't even getting no mochi this week. Cause it don't make sense to eat the whole fucking two boxes of mochi in 2 days. That shit is ridiculous. That's why I'm one fucking snack away from a motherfucking pooch, bitch. Yeah, it'll be fine. So there is that. Oh, it's so on my podcast, the little thumbnail today, it says, when you unclip her bra and crystals fall out. I remember one time I was me and Jackson, me and Jack in the Box was going upstairs. We was walking upstairs and and I had some me and my homeboy. We was walking up the stairs and this nigga, we was at work, and we was like, I used to take the stairs to kind of try to help me lose weight, because this was when I was a little bigger. And so one day we was walking up the stairs, and all my crystals fell out my bra. This was before we was close, but we wasn't super close. So he was like, bitches, what did rocks just fall out of your bra? And I was so ashamed, because I was like new to spiritualists. I was like, I think I had like a black tourmaline, some fucking citrine, and maybe like some rose quartz. He was like, did some rocks fall out your bra? I was like, where did they come from? I was like, oh, that was in my bra. And so I used to keep my crystals in my bra. That shit's so funny. So that's what I thought about when I saw that shit. I was just like, that's hilarious. That's hilarious. Cheers to old friends. But my lip gloss popping. So there is that. Fuck it. Fuck it, two tears, one bucket. We're going to let that shit run. Fuck it. So there's that. I thought I would share that with y'all. Y'all got to see this meme, though. I don't know if y'all can see it on my phone, but it's the son from Power, and he looks so confused, like, like, bitches, that rocks. That's funny. If your bitch don't got rocks in her bra, you ain't got the right bitch. I actually don't wear my crystals on my bra anymore. Like, my nail tech was like, you got a lot of bracelets. I just got bracelets. These bracelets cost an arm, a leg, and a fucking small child. But I get them in my mind for soul boxes. So there's that. All right, guys, I am going to, so I got my contacts in today, but I want to automatically adjust my glasses, but I don't have them hoes on, and I feel like I can't see, but I can see. I gotta take them out, because my eyes be getting dry, these toric lenses. And so, yeah, my hair look a mess, y'all. Don't judge me. I'm gonna do something to my hair. I gotta do something. Gotta be starting something. You wanna be starting something. Too high to get over. Yeah, yeah. Too young to get under. And you wanna know what? This Usher song, I'ma run that Make Me Better. I don't know. But that Usher Bad Habit song, I really don't like that shit. I'ma run Peace Sign. That's one of my shits too. I'm just really in the mellow vibe. I'm really trying to get back to a place where, like, I don't know, I'm just opening my heart. But I've been listening to a lot of love songs lately. Confession. I need love and affection. Love. Oh, this is my shit too. Zaytoven. I probably can't run it. Okay, let's see. It's my shit. All right, guys. Y'all have a blessed Tuesday. It's been Testimony Tuesday. You go get it, because you already know. If you don't, somebody else will. It's okay to not like the cringe and to not be happy because you're in the cringe. But just because you're in the cringe, sometimes you got to stop and realize that's where you're at. And then be like, you know what? It's a part of this. I hate it, but I got to keep going, because that lets me know if I'm in the right place. If it was easy, you wouldn't want it. You know what I'm saying? So Testimony Tuesday is still embrace the cringe, but you ain't gotta like the cringe while you in it, but be grateful for it. And like I said, I'm grateful for the cringe. I'm grateful for my job. I'm grateful for all the people, because I understand that everybody got, like, I just understand that everybody got a role to play. And now that I understand that everybody got a role to play, I don't even get, like, it just make me happy. And it's crazy. I feel a psycho, but I'm so happy. Like, I'm blessed late in the midnight hour. Y'all already know. God gonna turn it around.
Live TV from 85 plus channels with local sports and news. YouTube TV. Try it free.
I is my shit. That's my Usher ugly face. Y'all have a blessed day.